take a shot every time Holly does this. Shot! That's what I was whispering about. Cough, and she just recoils in disgust.
Hi guys, it is week 3 of my reverse diet, and we're gonna go over how it has progressed this week, what has changed with regards to my macros and my training, what I plan to do this week. So I'm kind of excited. So shall we get into it?
Yeah.
Right.
Teach you some more macros.
So we'll go over what my end of fat loss diet macros were, just very quickly for those of you that didn't see the first few weeks. But go and check that out if you haven't watched week 1 and week 2, because it really goes into detail about how we set this up and where I've come from. So in the end of my fat loss diet, if you want to come over here and have a look at the macros I finished on, that is the highlighted section just here. So I finished my diet on 145 protein, 135 fats and 40 fats and 135 carbs. So week 1, we've taken my carbs up to 145 and my fats up to 45. Then last week we took them up by another 10, so carbs still increasing and my fats have been increasing steadily as well. So to summarize my nutritional intakes for the week, I've just put together a little bit of a board for you. So Layne, do you want to talk through what you're actually looking at just here? Hopefully you can interpret my mess.
Yeah, so you've got her daily protein, carbohydrate and fats. As you can tell, she's very detail orientated.
Meticulous.
Yeah. So you can see here she was sick for 2 days. She fell short of her targets. And the rest of the week she was pretty compliant. Mm-hmm. She was a little bit low on fats here, mm-hmm. a little bit high on carbs here. But overall, she was close to her goal. She was a little bit high on protein, a little low on carbs, pretty low on fats.
Mm-hmm. They're my averages just
and
here.
And her calories were actually low. So she didn't gain any weight, right?
Mm-hmm. Actually, I gained 200 grams this week. So the end of last week, I finished my reverse diet at 66.5. And this week, I actually woke up at 66.7.
So. Yeah, but your average is 66.6.
It is.
It says it right there.
That's not my average. That's my weight recorded on the day. This is me and Layne having a disagreement right now. That is my weight on Tuesday morning, right okay. here. So week 1 was 66.5.
What's your average though?
66.6. It hasn't changed. That is it.
But you just said it was 66.7.
This morning it was.
Okay, but you need to be focusing on your average, not what you woke up at this morning.
Okay, my average has stayed at 66.6.
Right, so you're holding steady. But you were short by a little bit.
Yeah, I was 83 calories per day below what I should have been.
Which pretty much you were on the macros from the previous week then. Mm. Basically is what that says, that you didn't actually do the increase that you were supposed to. But again, you were sick and there were some other things.
Yeah, well, I actually took 2 days off training this week as well. So you can see here I got 3 weight training sessions in. And I did do 2 cardio sessions. But usually these 2 would also be training, so I missed 2 sessions. It's hard to know whether the sickness that I had was actually as energy demanding or protein energy demanding as my regular training sessions, because we do know that when you're unwell and you have an illness, your metabolic rate does seem to increase to accommodate all of the things going on. You know,
increased cytokine production,
exactly.
Inflammation.
Yeah.
There's a lot
of energy.
Your immune
system is really ramped up at that point in time. So I probably think that even though I didn't train, I was kind of balancing out my calories, to be honest, even though I still tried to hit my targets on that day. So in fact, that was probably my best day. This day I was sick. This is my target and I got within 2 calories of it. So that's good.
Well, I think we should probably go with an increase, but a relatively conservative increase this week. Just because looking at the fact that
I was a little under.
You were under, you didn't gain weight, but you were under. So I would say probably increase carbohydrates by 10 grams and fats by 1 or 2 grams.
Yeah, I was thinking relatively conservative. So, okay, so this week I'm going to keep my targets at 160 for my protein, so that won't change. And my carbohydrates are going to go from 155 to 165. And I'm going to take my fats from 47 to 49, being very conservative this week, just to make sure that we're not overstepping anything. And obviously the biggest thing for me with this reverse diet is to try and maintain my weight as I am. So I want to really try and focus on pushing my metabolism, you know, to the most that I possibly can. So we'll go in and put those new targets in, 160, 165, and 49, and then we can see my new calorie target will be 1714.
Girl, you're making it rain with calories.
I know, that's pretty good. I'm happy with that little 3-week increase. I've taken up 200 calories in 2 weeks and not changed my weight, so I'm pumped for that. Bring on 300.
So now to get to 200 first.
I have so many clients at the moment. I was telling Layne this morning, there's one gal, she's 115 pounds and she's on like 320 grams of carbs and 75 fats. Her protein is obviously a little lower, so it brings her calories down overall, but I was just like, damn, I'm so jealous right now. But I've got to keep in mind too, like what we do for work is pretty sedentary. Like we are just here coaching all day every day or not really doing a whole lot of much, to be honest. So it definitely makes a big difference. Even like that's why we have standing desks, like to increase your NEAT during the day. Like I've noticed, you know, I can probably eat another 100 calories just if I choose to stand for the times that I'm working. So yeah, that is something else to consider, is what you do for your occupation. Like you can't really compare to somebody that is super busy and has a laborious job versus somebody that is an engineer and sits in there in front of their computer all day. But yeah, you win some, you lose some there.
I agree. You still have plenty of energy for training.
That is true.
How do you find that out? Because you used to have a very up on your feet all day sort of job. Do you find you have more energy now for training or more energy back then?
That's a really good question. My training style has changed so much that I feel like I can't really compare them fairly. Previously, like I used to do, and you'd know, like my training style was higher rep range, lighter loads. I might still achieve the same volume overall.
Jumping around like some kind
but
of
I was
rabbit.
Just like energy bunny, absolute energy bunny. And that's just what I was enjoying at the time. I didn't have any specific powerlifting or strength goals. So I just got into the gym and I really like to sweat. It was almost like cardio. Like to be honest, like if I try and do some of those things now, like one set of 15 at like a fairly decent weight, my lungs are like exploding. So I don't know. I couldn't comment fairly, to be honest, because I do such a different style now. But it's better. I enjoy this way, like so much more.
Oh really?
Yeah. Like I don't have to really. I don't feel like I'm exerting myself quite as much when I train like this. It's, yeah, don't squint at me like that. I find it easier physically. Obviously it's very challenging mentally to prepare for like a one rep max and a three rep max. You have to be very focused. You've done this for years. What do you think about it?
Yeah, I would say the same thing. Bodybuilding training was more. Well, in a way, powerlifting training is still more physically demanding just because of how much it beats you up. But in terms of the actual training itself, during the training, yes, it's more muscularly fatiguing and more pain from like a deep muscle ache or deep, you know, metabolic byproduct accumulation. We're still swelling, but powerlifting is more mentally challenging to focus yourself and put all of your focus and energy into one set and then do it again and then do it again and do it again. That's very difficult.
I must say, I think looking back at like my training history and my caloric intakes, like to be able to do this style of training, I don't think I would be able to do the lifts on such restricted intakes. Like
I think I've been able to get by doing bodybuilding style training programs on very low calories because
You're not worried about the weights you're using.
I'm not worried about the weights. Like, I still feel safe, pretty safe, like lifting, you know, if I'm doing a squat or something, it might have only been 60 kilos. Like, it's not super ridiculous. So you can kind of get by on low calories, but there's no way that you can do that for this kind of training. So yeah, I guess that's one of the reasons I'm super pumped to be doing this reverse, because it's going to work really nicely with the powerlifting meet coming up in the end of May. So I got to.
I think you're right.
I wonder how I'm gonna go with this. This will be very interesting. All right, guys. So I'm gonna leave you with a physique update. You can judge for yourself or be the determiner of whether you think I've put on body fat. I don't know, but my calories have gone up by 250 since I finished my, actually more than that, it was 14, 15, 16, 17. It's around 300 calories since I finished my diet, and yeah, my weight hasn't really moved. It's like 200 grams, give or take, which is really, really cool. So yeah, I hope you're learning from this reverse dieting series. Keep watching, follow us along. If you're not subscribed to Layne's channel, hit him up on BioLayne. And you can follow me as well. Yeah. I hope you have a really great day, guys. Thanks for watching. I've been fucking hoes and popping pillies, man. I feel just like a rock star. All my brothers got that gas and they always be smoking like a rock star. Fucking with me, call up on the Uzi and show up, man. Them the shot toss. When my homies pull up on your block, they make that thing go grata ta ta. I've been in the hills, fucking superstars, feeling like a pop star. Drinking Henny, bad bitches jumping in the pool, and I ain't got on no bra. Hit her front or back, pulling on the tracks, and now she screaming out no more. They like Savage, why you got a 12?